Hey guys, my name is Carmen Mohan and I am the CEO and founder of Straight.Tax. And what's very important for us as business owners and entrepreneurs, especially first generation entrepreneurs, is for us to understand how to manage our business finances. And whether your business makes $50,000 or $500,000, I really feel like there's five pillars to actually managing your business finances and what that looks like. The first pillar that we're gonna talk about today is investing in our business. As we invest in our business, there are gonna be some things that we need to know. The first thing we're gonna need to know is how much are we investing in our business? You can't actually earn back the income that you spent investing in your business until you know what that actual dollar amount is, right? So it's gonna be very important if you're taking notes, which you should be, it's gonna be very important for you to understand how much you are into your investment into your business and keeping track of actually how much you've invested into your business thus far. Then you're gonna need to make sure that the things that you're actually investing in are going to bring you an ROI. For those of you that don't know what ROI means, it's return on investment. The second pillar in how to manage your finances is going to be to project your returns on your business and make sure that you're tracking these projections, right? And in order to track the projections, you need to know what that looks like. And what that's gonna look like is simple formula. And for those of you taking notes, I want you to write it down, KPIs. Your key performance indicators is what KPI stands for. And KPI is going to be the things that you need to track and measure in order to be able to figure out, is this said expense actually bringing me a return on my investment? Once you figure out what you're actually tracking, and that could be how many different products you have to sell to get to your initial investment. That could look how much sales does my business have to generate in the first month to meet the actual amount I've invested in my company. You're gonna need to figure out what your KPIs are, and then from there, that's going to help you determine what is the return on investment on these actual expenses. And then from there, you're gonna wanna make sure that you're building revenue from what you're actually investing in, right? You have to do that constantly. You have to go, as you're managing your business finances, and especially as a first generation entrepreneur, we like to spend a lot, right? Especially if you come from poverty, you're probably used to spending a lot. Maybe you've never seen any type of money. If you're starting out a business, you've never actually earned $50,000 or $100,000 or $500,000 in this new machine that you created. And so managing that new machine is going to look a lot differently when you're thinking about actually spending money on all of these expenses. So you're gonna have to pay close attention to what you're spending money on and then figure out what is the actual return on this investment. And you can do that by first figuring out your KPIs, then figuring out what the return on investment is, and actually make sure you're building revenue from the things that you invested in. Now, let's say you start generating some income. So now your expenses are low. You want to keep your expenses low. Let's say your expenses are low. Now you're actually generating some revenue. Now you're trying to figure out how much revenue do you need to make to actually be profitable? Now is when you actually need to start to work with a tax accountant. And let me tell you why. At this point, when you actually start generating some revenue and you're keeping your expenses low, and now you're maybe even generating a profit, it's important for you at that point to actually sit down with a tax accountant or a specialist to be able to help you do a couple things that you're gonna need to do in order to manage your business finances. And the accounting piece of it is gonna be pillar number three. The accounting piece are gonna be the things that you're gonna wanna track with an accountant is gonna be your cash flow. Your cash flow. You wanna be able to understand how much cash is maintaining within your account after your expenses. How much operating expenses do you have from month to month, and what does a healthy percentage of operating expenses look like for your particular business. Everyone's company is different. Everyone's business is different. The way we all generate revenue is different. So it's going to change from person to person and company to company on how much your cash flow projection should be, on how much percentage of profit you should be at, on what your healthy standpoint for your company looks like. May look a lot different than what my healthy standpoint for my type of company in my industry looks like. So number three, the accounting piece is so important. And this is where a lot of businesses fail. You know, we're just coming out of COVID. Things are starting a little bit to get normal. How many businesses did not survive during COVID? A lot. I don't have a percentage off the top of my head, but I can tell you across the nation, all 50 states, probably millions, right? Or hundreds of thousands, right? And the reason being is that a lot of them did not have their business finances or their personal finances in place, and they weren't prepared for a rainy day. And a lot of them possibly were not even working with accountants or good accountants to help them really figure out, where am I at now in my company's finances? And what does this look like now? So am I prepared for a rainy day? Am I prepared for a high tax bill? Am I prepared, you know, even when all of the COVID relief programs were released for business owners, there were a lot of business owners that didn't get to actually get any COVID relief loans, EIDL or PPP, because they weren't prepared to do so. Their company wasn't structured in a way that they actually had all their taxes filed. They were actually paying taxes on profit. They weren't actually equipped for a rainy day. And a lot of business owners actually saw the fact that them not having their finances in order really, really hurt them. And so some of them actually didn't get to even make it through COVID. Others made it through COVID, but they weren't able to actually qualify for any funding relief that the government programs release, all of the funding programs. Let's talk about action number four, or the fourth pillar, like I like to say, profit. The next thing that's gonna happen is your accountant is gonna determine how much profit and or loss you made. If you made a loss, you're gonna have to go back to the accounting piece and do some adjusting. But if you actually made a profit, what's gonna happen next is that you're going to have to pay taxes on this profit. Now let's remember, our main goal, for those of you taking notes, our main goal is to generate a profit. And in order to generate a profit, you have to be able to be tracking all of your expenses, all of your income, work with an accountant. And once you have these three pillars in place, or these five pillars in place, you'll be able to do that a lot simpler. Especially as first generation entrepreneurs, because again, no one actually paved the way for you to understand how to earn income, pay expenses, build a company, generate hundreds of thousands of dollars, manage hundreds of thousands of dollars, manage team members, you know, or even six-figure payrolls, right? At some point you're gonna get there, and you need to be able to take the baby steps it takes to actually get there. So your main goal is going to be to generate a profit in your business. So in order for you to generate a profit in your business, you're going to have certain things in place to make sure that you actually are generating the profit. And then the last pillar of managing your business finances, number five, is going to be taxes. After you have gained your profit, which means, however, your total amount of gross revenue your business made minus all your expenses, that's what's gonna equal your profit. Then from there, you're gonna have to, guess what? You're gonna have to pay Uncle Sam. You're gonna have to pay taxes. And then from there, how do you determine your tax rate? You're gonna have to pay taxes on your profit, and your tax rate is going to be determined based on the type of corporation that you have, based on the other income that you've had, based on your filing status, based on your familial marital situation. That's gonna determine your tax rate. So the fifth step and the last step and the step where a lot of business owners also get taken back by is when it comes time to pay Uncle Sam. So I want you guys to really think about this. And I'm gonna do a quick overview from one to five. When we're thinking about managing our company finances and managing our business finances, we're gonna wanna go through these five steps. The first one's going to be to invest in our company. The second one is gonna be to project your return on the investment in your company and actually learn what that looks like to track that, right? Then the third is gonna be, we wanna make sure we have our accounting in place. And in order to do so, we're gonna wanna work with a great tax accountant, because the tax accountant is gonna be your partner in building your company and your business. And then we wanna make sure we're generating a profit. We wanna be profitable. You're technically not a business if you're not profitable. You're just a hobby in the eyes of the IRS. Actually, if you claim a loss for 3 or more years with the IRS, they actually deem you as a hobby and will actually turn your company inactive. Sidebar. But let's go back to this. The fourth one is profit, and the fifth one is taxes. This is a great foundation for all business owners, whether you make $50,000, $500,000, or $5 million, this is what it's gonna look like to actually build and manage your company finances. Again, my name is Carmen Mohan, and if you need help in managing your finances, one of our specialists over at Straight.Tax can certainly help you. We know small business, we understand, we get it, and we work with a lot of small business owners just like yourself that need help in navigating managing their business finances. I hope this video helped you. And if you ever need help beyond this, feel free to reach out to one of our specialists today. Thank you.